Can I ask you a serious question? Where are you? In front of a computer screen? In a body? In your home? In a city? On a planet? Are you in love? In pain? What is all this stuff that you see and you feel? What's it for? Where are you? And why are you there? If you really think about it, it's pretty clear that the answer to those questions holds the answer to every other possible question. And the only thing preventing us from getting the answer is the way we perceive reality. Because if we could see it for what it really is, then we would know for sure where we came from, what we are, where we're going, and why everything happens. So what is it about the way that we perceive that stops us from knowing? What's keeping us in the dark? Okay, let's start out here. This is the whole of reality. What we think of as other dimensions, non-material potential. Everything that's hidden from us, our future. What we want to feel but can't. What we want to know but don't know yet. For some reason, we have no sense of this. So to us, it's as though it doesn't exist at all. And what is all of this? Unlimited pleasure. Unbounded existence, complete perception, and connection with the force that builds and guides the material universe, where we are. This is us, a closed box with five little openings to what surrounds us. And even though we have these five senses to tell us what's real and to guide us, none of them works in a way capable of sensing anything that's out here for what it actually is.
The problem is, this is where we all really live.
Yet we only experience what you find in there. And what you find in there is limited perception, isolation, fleeting pleasures, and all kinds of problems that cause suffering.
Why don't we experience what's out here?
Instead of what's in here? When something from the total of reality comes calling, we think we know what it is. But we never get the thing itself. It never actually enters the box, because the senses aren't really openings. What's outside the box hits some kind of resistance, a screen, a barrier, like an eardrum, or a retina, a taste bud, or a nerve that interprets what's outside, and then gives it an identity and a meaning, according to the effect that this unknown thing might have on the box. But the interpretation that the sensor gives us is entirely limited to the way it's programmed. The program doesn't tell us what the outer objective reality actually is. It reduces it, turning it into something else according to its rules. And all of our senses run on the exact same program. So, whether your eye uses an electron microscope or the Hubble Space Telescope, what you'll ultimately see will always be a subjective picture, determined and controlled by the program. So what exactly is the program? It's called egoism. Self-concern. How does this affect me? What do I get out of this? In other words, the will to receive. The box is a machine. The input, a formless unknown that gets processed through an inner program. And the output of the machine is our reality. But this isn't real reality. It's just the way it appears to the will to receive.
Because out here, everything operates according to a different, all-encompassing program that only creates, sustains, and guides.
It has absolutely no self-concern, so it has no limitations. It is unconditional altruism. The general law of the universe. The single benevolent force behind all nature and existence. It's the thing that gives you your life. This is the complete polar opposite of the box. It's like comparing the Big Bang to a black hole. It is so unlike the reason behind everything we feel, want, and do, that as long as we measure life through the five senses and the will to receive, we will never know our true nature, the nature of reality, or the purpose of our lives. The end. You don't really think that this is the end, do you? Because that would mean that life was designed to be cruel and senseless. And even though it sometimes feels that way, like right now, there's a point inside you that's sure that there's a way out of this narrow existence. and there is. But it all depends on how you desire. When the need to get out of the box finally becomes strong enough, a different kind of desire appears as a tiny point in your consciousness. And the only thing that it wants is to be directly connected with the program outside of the box. Once this point of desire is awakened, if you know how to develop it, it can grow to become the basis of a completely new, non-physical sense that can perceive the greater reality, and even the thought of the force behind it. How can that happen? It can happen because there's a principle of non-physical nature called equivalence of form. In the physical world, you can take two things that are very different in form and quality, and you can put them near each other in space and say they're close. But out here, there is no time, no space, and there are no separate objects like there are in the physical. Out here, there are only forces, fields of influence, varying levels of bestowal that resemble the thought behind the general law of the universe. In the non-physical, if things have different qualities, they're distant. If they have similar qualities, they're close. But if they have exactly the same quality, feeling, and purpose, then they are in fact the same thing. They're inseparable, bonded.
So this opposite egoistic quality of the five senses
blocks our perception, gives us the experience of separation, isolation, and constant lack.
That embryonic point in your heart is unconsciously similar in quality and feeling to the unseen world. It's intimately connected and interwoven with it. And the stronger your desire to transform your inner program to be like the outer one, the closer it brings you to know and enter it.
And to see that everything in your life, every desire, every joy, every disappointment, is really the general law of the universe guiding reality to develop and awaken you to consciously come into balance with it so that you can receive what it most wants to give you, the ability to be just like it, so that what it feels, you feel, what it knows, you know, and what it can do, you can do. The method of developing this additional sense is called Kabbalah. Kabbalah is not religion. It's not mysticism or magic. It's the user's manual for reality. It's a map of our sensations and feelings. It explains how our inner and outer worlds are constructed and why. It's a science, so fundamental that it can only be called wisdom. Kabbalah has been passed down through an unbroken chain from teacher to student over thousands of years, kept hidden until the time when humanity would reach the need, the stage in its development, where it could properly understand and use it. That time is now. The RE Institute is a non-profit organization making authentic Kabbalah available to anyone who needs it, regardless of religion, nationality, age, or gender. If that point in your heart really wants to know more, here are the links. The end. No, really, it's the end.